Hello, in today's lecture, we focus on the use of a microbalance in setting up models for the design of equipment in the process industries. A microbalance can be seen as a balance over a very small volume. The question is, when do we use this type of balance? In the chemical industry, we use different types of equipment where reactions take place, components are separated, all with the final objective to obtain the right bulk chemicals or products. Equipment where chemicals are mixed and react are called reactors. We can distinguish many different types of reactors, for example, batch reactors, multiphase reactors, continuous flow reactors. Over all these reactors, we set up mass balances and energy balances to calculate, for example, the change of concentration in time or the change of temperature in the reacting fluid. To illustrate the principle of a microbalance, we take a chemical reaction in a so-called plug flow reactor. A plug flow reactor is a pipe where the reaction starts in the beginning of the tube and ends at the end of the tube. So the composition of the reacting mixture varies as a function of the place. For simplicity, we neglect the effects of diffusion and assume a constant density of the mixture and that the concentration of the key component, A, decreases in the direction of the tube exit. If we set up a macro mass balance over the whole plug flow reactor, we obtain under steady state conditions that the mass entering the reactor is equal to the mass which leaves the reactor. However, if we want to know what the concentration of a reacting component is at any place in the reactor or at the end of the reactor, we need another approach, the so-called microbalance. To get information about the change of the concentration of a component A, we need to set up a mass balance over a small part of the tube between X and X plus dx, as is illustrated in the figure. In this small volume, the concentration at X is CAX and becomes CAX plus dx. If the volume flow rate is constant and we assume a first order reaction in this volume, we can write the steady state microbalance as follows. This is the basis of a microbalance. As you notice, we only consider a very small volume of the tube between X and X plus dx. And look how the concentration of the component A changes as a function of the length of the reactor. If we divide all the terms by dx and take the limit of dx approaches zero, we obtain the following differential equation. The solution of this equation can be obtained by integration and using the boundary conditions that the concentration A at the beginning of the tube is equal to Ca zero, which gives this equation shows that the concentration exponentially decreases as a function of the distance of the beginning at the tube and the ends and ends at the x is L with the concentration. In this equation, the volume V is the volume of the whole tubular reactor. The concept of the microbalance is often used in transport phenomena, in particular if concentration or temperature changes as a function of place and time. This can be in Cartesian coordinates like x and x plus dx, or in cylindrical or spherical coordinates between r and r plus dr. You will see many examples of microbalances in this course. Let's illustrate the microbalance with an example of the slow drug release of a pill. The active component diffuses slowly from the surface of the pill into its surroundings. Consider a balance between r and r plus dr, and assume that the concentration at the surface of the pill is constant. And far away from this pill, the surface concentration is about zero. Apply a microbalance between R and R plus dr and assume only Fickian diffusion. This results in take the limit of dr goes to zero and solve the resulting differential equation and look if you obtain the same result as I. You see that the local concentration decreases with the reciprocal value of the distance. So, we explained to you the concept of a microbalance. Try it now by yourself. Thanks for your attention and success.